Assalamualaikum, selamat datang ke Career Cube Live.
Live.
Minggu ini kita ada penampilan istimewa bersama kami. Kita jemput partner kami yang bermula hubungan ini since tahun lepas, berterusan tahun ini dan akan berterusan pada tahun-tahun akan datang, kerana mereka adalah orang yang tepat memiliki data-data penting yang graduan perlu tahu. Alright, so bersama dengan saya di Career Cube Live minggu ini adalah Tuan Alfred Liu. Selamat datang, Tuan.
Terima kasih.
Tuan Alfred adalah merupakan tim daripada Grab Malaysia, yang kalau anda biasa dengar Grab Malaysia, one of it adalah dia adalah portal pekerjaan. Kedua, dia menyediakan satu platform untuk anda cari kerja, iaitu Career Fair. Nanti kita kongsi lebih lanjut. Dan juga mereka menjalankan satu anugerah yang very grand punya anugerah untuk syarikat-syarikat. Anda tak tahu tak apa, kita kongsikan selepas ini. So, share live ini. Kita akan dedahkan kepada anda tentang apakah teknik-teknik job hunting yang relevan untuk tahun 2020. Method lama sesuai ke? Ada method yang baru? So, share live ini kepada rakan-rakan anda. Share. Boleh join bersama-sama dengan rakan-rakan anda. Tinggalkan komen jika ada persoalan. Kami akan jawab selepas habis live ini. Alright. Okay, boleh? Baik, tanpa melengahkan masa, mari kita teruskan. Tuan Alfred merupakan salah seorang yang aktif berkongsi di seluruh Malaysia, betul ya?
Ya, betul.
Ke mana tuan pernah pergi?
Oh, banyak campus. Kebanyakan IPTA dan semua IPTS dekat Malaysia ni. Selagi ada jemputan daripada yes. Kampus-kampus tu nak bagi macam career talk ke ataupun seminar untuk para graduan, tim kami akan berada dekat situ untuk berkongsi maklumat pasal tentang graduate employability.
Itu dia. So, kami jemput orang yang tepat. Ya, kita jemput speaker juga. He will share a lot of things, input. Kehebatan Grab Malaysia, tuan-tuan cikpuan, adalah mereka memegang satu data yang mahal. Dan data-data daripada mereka, kami pun pinjam. Kami pun ambil dan kami kongsikan kepada anda juga di platform-platform kami. Baik, berbicara tentang memburu kerja, sekarang adalah bulan Januari. So, baru buka SEM. Yang final sem, yang third sem, nak cari intern, mula Feb ada. So, mari kita meneroka apakah method-method job hunting yang paling common sekali. Yang paling biasa dengar adalah sekarang buka job portal, one of it Grab Malaysia, Job Street, lain-lain job portal banyak, and then create account, click apply. Apakah itu berkesan, tuan? Dan kalau berkesan, ada study case? Kalau tak berkesan, what is the best approach?
Okay. Bagi pandangan Alfred, buat macam ni. Sebenarnya tak ada satu format ataupun satu trend di mana kita boleh cakap dia lagi berkesan untuk memburu pekerjaan tu. So, usually bagi macam sekarang ni bulan January.
Okay.
So what will happen is there's a lot of students are actually preparing for job search sebab nak dekat dengan dia punya graduation dah.
Yep.
If not, then it's coming to the end of their semester.
Betul.
Jadi what I would suggest us to do is you have to be creative, you have to think out of the box. For example, how do you want to approach for a job search, or how do you want to approach a majikan untuk dapat maklumat pasal tentang sesuatu pekerjaan tu.
Right.
And very often or not, the traditional way or the modern way, I call it, in the millennium.
Okay.
So a lot of people are actually depending on the technology.
Yes.
Seperti, you know, apply jobs on job portal. And my advice is that for any graduates out there, if you really would, you prefer that medium untuk cari kerja, you kena pandai juga.
Pandai macam mana tu?
Okay. You kena pergi study. Antara banyak job portal ni kan, mana satu yang you akan dapat maklumat lebih dari maklumat yang lebih dari yang mengenai tentang
company.
Graduate job.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Sebab ada setengah job portal tu kan, dia dia focus is actually only for nak cari pekerja yang ada pengalaman.
Okay, menarik.
And there are certain portal, they are actually championing for graduate jobs. I tak boleh
banyak
sangat. So you have to go and do your research. You kena tengok mana satu portal yang lebih sesuai.
I see.
And sometimes applying for a job is not so much about just click the button and then submit your resume mm-hmm. and then apply straight away.
Yes.
I think it's important for us to also not to forget that you need to establish a very strong networking with employers. Yeah. You kena bagi satu first impression yang sangat bagus. Mm-hmm. Katakanlah dalam musim ni kan, okay. musim cari kerja yang memang peak. Yeah. Yang okay. Starting daripada bulan Januari sampailah April, I would say, mm-hmm. yeah, because that's the season where a lot of people are actually getting their bonuses,
yeah.
and a lot of you know people are considering whether they should go for a job change then, or they want to hop for another better job.
Oh, see, inilah dia punya window.
Macam tu. So I would say this is also the same period where you will be expecting a lot of like career events in the market. Whether it's a career fair or maybe it's a you know HR conference and whatever not, those are all very good avenue for the graduates or for any job seekers mm-hmm. to go out there and attend those events. Your intention should be very simple, mm-hmm. which is to establish a networking with the employer.
For example,
if let's say you're a graduate in engineering,
okay,
right?
Engineer.
So sometimes it's difficult for us to reach out to the HR manager kan.
Betul.
So sometimes what we do is we go to the company website, study dia punya latar belakang mm-hmm. and also do research which position are they hiring. But that's not enough, because what is more important is that you need to get to the right person, the right contact person. So in order for you to capture the right person, you need to go to all these events. So you have to follow up with all these company punya social media platform ke.
Kalau melalui job portal, kita takkan jumpa orang tu?
Tak. So what we'll do is you need to attend this event and then you have to take the opportunity to introduce yourself mm-hmm. and then at the same time to establish the first contact mm-hmm. and once you have the contact then you can follow up later on. I think that's very important, is to create the first impression. And a lot of time we always depend on the technology.
True.
We think that you know
I dah submit.
Ya betul. Kenapa tak ada respon? How come?
Just click and wait.
Yeah, you shouldn't wait. You need to be proactive.
Yes.
You need to take the aggressive
Tepat
move.
Tepat sekali.
Yeah, so you have to be one step in advance. Mm-hmm. Because the job market is very competitive. Every year, if I'm not wrong, Malaysia is actually producing about 200,000 graduates.
Yes.
Yeah.
Every year.
Yes. And looking at the job market right now, how many jobs are actually being offered in the market? So you also need to think that you are basically competing with people who have actually graduated years ago, mm-hmm. not just from your same batch.
Yang dah menganggur setahun.
Ya betul. So the job market is very competitive.
Yes.
In order for you to win that race or you know menonjol dari dalam
to shine,
you need to do the extra steps.
That's
so if you ask my opinion, which is the method which is more berkesan, mm-hmm. I would say there's no
berkesan.
But it's the extra effort that you need to put in.
Bahasa mudah buat semua.
Yeah. And I would also advise any graduates out there, please don't hantam saja. What am I trying to say is, you shouldn't just go to a job portal and then look at every related jobs that you think that you will be able to get a response from the employer, mm-hmm. and then you just click hantar.
Without study further.
And also this is very dangerous move, because you might think that you have applied for 100 jobs, so kebarangkalian untuk dapat satu mungkin besar kan, but not the case.
So even you are submitting macam yang tak ada quality.
Betul.
I see.
So you need to be really focused in terms of what you want to achieve and how do you get to know that contact person. That's the first thing that you must do.
Alright, so menarik. Klik sahaja sangat tidak mencukupi. Alright, Tuan Alfred kata, bagi tahu, one of it adalah cara ekstra anda boleh buat adalah go for networking. Event banyak Tuan Alfred kongsi tadi.
Yep.
Macam-macam event boleh join. Yang paling basic adalah career fair. Kalau sekarang Januari, standby 29 Februari dan juga 1 Mac di KLCC. Standby, simpan dalam diri anda, ada career fair yang sangat besar akan berlaku, iaitu Mega Career and Study Fair. So ini adalah tempat kita boleh cari the right contact person.
Yep.
Tuan Alfred, kalau kita pergi career fair, let's say we pergi pada company A. Mm. Let's say dia ada 2-3 orang yang jaga. How what is the best approach? Macam mana kita nak jumpa, nak tahu the right person?
Okay, I think first of all, when you meet up an employer at mm-hmm. career fair kan, you need to introduce yourself regardless who are you talking to, mm-hmm. because sometimes the people who are actually duty dekat booth tu kan, they might not be the hiring manager.
I see.
Maybe they're just the HR executive, macam pembantu. But what you can do is you can actually speak to the person after introducing yourself, and then ask that person, how can I submit this application to your company? Am I supposed to submit it to the hiring department, or is the hiring manager here today so that I can speak further? So you need to ask that kind of question instead of just appear in front of the booth. Then people sometimes will put a, what you call that, the resume box.
Yes.
Then you drop saja. Memang tak cukup. Because you need to establish the first impression. That's what I've been saying.
Yes. Important. Establish the first impression.
Yeah, you kena bagi satu macam impression yang bagus untuk majikan tu.
Betul.
Even though not asking you to be the most beautiful candidate or the most handsome candidate, but
yang paling heboh bukan?
Yeah, betul. Bukan macam tu. So you need to establish a very good impression. People will think that, hey, this person is very proactive. This person is very approachable. Hey, tadi dia datang ke booth kita orang, he and she can strike a conversation. Mm-hmm. And instantly, I form a good impression about this candidate. This is the kind of person that I would want to consider to hire. Macam tu lah.
Sesimple itu sahaja, just start a conversation, ask appropriate question. Soalan yang betul akan mengundang jawapan yang betul. So how kita nak cari orang yang betul, then ask question, ladies and gentlemen. Menarik sekali. Okay, baik. So tidak ada satu cara yang kita kata buat ini, confirm inilah yang paling berkesan. Nope. Dia memerlukan multiple effort. Online, you click apply, tak ada masalah. But you need to establish your first impression, bina networking, pergi kepada event. You need to do that sebab anda compete dengan banyak orang. Alright. So, 200 ribu yang grad setiap tahun, tak campur yang menganggur sebelum-sebelum
betul
tu. So, let's say kalau saya baca artikel sebelum ni, Google setahun dia terima dalam 300 ribu job application. One year. So, kalau syarikat besar-besar, ini adalah sejumlah yang agak biasa. Usually dalam pengalaman Tuan Alfred sendiri, apakah yang common mistake berlaku dalam application? Either it's offline application ataupun online application.
Okay.
Mistake-mistake yang sekali tengok macam, oh tidak, buang. macam itulah.
Right. I think it boils down to the preparation of what you have studied and also your research about the job before you apply. First thing, the very important thing that I've been sharing with a lot of graduates, you must tell in the resume or in the application form what are you looking for? What is
in
your
term
objective?
Of position. Betul. Okay.
Katakanlah in your resume, kan? So maybe you would want to consider to put down your career objective. For example, I'm a dedicated graduate who just completed my study in Bachelor of Marketing. And currently I'm actually seeking for a job opportunity in the related field so that I can actually apply my knowledge and also my skill sets in that job. So that thing is the very first step. You need to state down your career objective in a very clear statement.
Yes.
So when a recruiter receive your document, they will know, understand what position are you trying to apply for. Whether you're going for internship or you're going for a fresh graduate job or you're looking for a more executive mini position.
Nak tahu junior entrance, mid entrance, senior entrance. I see.
So that's the first thing that you need to explain. And the second part is that when you apply for a job, right, you must sangat penting. Study job scope tu. Job scope tu tak boleh lari.
Yes.
You don't simply just tembak.
You mentioned as well before this adalah main hantar saja sampai 100 and you expect dengan moga-moga lah ada rezeki satu. Which is tak
not,
boleh.
Not the right way. Not the right way. So
you need to study
the job scope. Tengoklah whether or not you have the hard skill or the soft skill to fulfill the job requirement.
Baru apply.
Macam tu. And the third thing you need to do is to really, really study about the company background. Yang tu sangat penting.
Example of company background?
For example, where is the company operate?
Okay.
Yeah, how big is their team? And whether or not this company is hiring students from which background. So you kena study by back tau. So a lot of people actually tend to ignore all these little details dalam job position tu or in the iklan itself. They will just ignore. They will just focus on the position that the company want to hire. Oh, yang ni, I nak. Tapi dia tak.
You are thinking about yourself only.
Correct. You're not thinking about how you can contribute back to the job or for the company. Yang tu yang penting sangat.
Yes. So, tuan-tuan, cik puan, anda fikir tentang diri anda nak kerja, which is betul lah. Tak ada salah. But you need to think on the other side, di pihak syarikat, kenapa dia nak ambil kita. So kenapa dia nak ambil kita adalah because we can contribute to the company. So macam mana kita matching lah, apa yang company nak kita supply kan. Company demand apa kita berikan. So that's betulnya saya ringkaskan begitu. So company dia ada needs dia, dia ada requirement dia. That's why they publish iklan yang ada job scope, job description dan sebagainya. So you need to study that first. Oh Mr. Alfred, kenapa benda-benda yang background tu penting eh? Macam kena tahu company besar mana, syarikat size located dekat mana, operation dekat mana.
Because sometimes right, there are certain jobs will require you to be repositioned to another branch office.
Okay.
So you need to get ready whether you are the kind of person who can accept the kind of flexibility
kena relocate.
To transfer. Ya betul, relocate semua tu.
Nanti so, kena relocate letak jawatan terus.
We actually see that a lot. And you know, sometimes when a person or a candidate they got a job, but without finding out whether this job required them to relocate to other branch office, and the moment when they find out, right, they become very stressful. Sebab tak ada transport ke, they feel like, you know, that place is so far away from his home or her home, and then the next moment is to tender resignation. So this is not a good sign.
Betul.
Yeah, it also shows that you are not willing to take the extra step.
True.
You are not willing to contribute more to the company.
Yes.
And a lot of time in the modern society, I think a lot of our employers are actually looking for candidates who can multitask and who can actually do more for the company and who have the willingness to go, learn and explore.
To go extra mile for the company.
It's not like you are just entering to a job and you're telling the employer, this is only what I can do. When the moment when you set that boundary, telling people what you can do only, that is not going to bring you further to your then, to your career.
You're already limiting yourself as well.
You shouldn't limit.
Yep.
Yeah.
Menarik. Wah, ini dah lamsam semua soalan ni.
Actually, I pun ada satu advice untuk student-student yang belajar macam engineering semua tu.
Okay.
More technical subject.
And technical side. Okay.
So in your resume, it is also very important for you to also spell out all the hard skills or the technical skills that you learn from what you have studied.
Okay, for example?
For example, engineering students, program yang biasa di belajar tu apa, MATLAB.
Oh, MATLAB.
C++ semua tu
kan.
So all these are the hard skills that you need to emphasize in your resume. Yeah, and we noticed that many of the technical program students, right, they don't usually promote themselves in terms of this part of the hard skill knowledge. For example, some students will come to us, they will tell us I don't have any working experience, but how should I enhance my resume? What should I emphasize more in the resume? Is it about my curriculum activities? Is it about my high school performance? Okay, to be honest to you,
the first point to emphasize is
what I'm trying to share with you is that if let's say you really don't have much work experience or you have limited experience, the best thing for you to talk about in your resume is talk about your hard skills. What have you learned in your engineering program?
Yeah.
I'm also pretty confident that all of the engineering students that have gone through like the final year project or they do some sort of like special project in their studies.
That require research and do apply their skills.
It can be like a prototype as well.
Yeah, betul.
Yeah. So you need to mention all those single projects into your resume. Because those are the hard skills that a lot of employees want to see from you. And that will win you extra points in getting a job. Even though you don't have much work experience, it's okay.
Acceptable, fresh grad.
Acceptable. But you need to enhance your employability through your hard skills, through your final projects.
So, bila kita scan resume, antara few points yang capture the eye of hiring recruiter adalah this hard skill lah.
Betul.
Yang pertama usually memang pengalaman kerja lah. If you have related work experience, itu memang paling mahal. And then if you're fresh grad, it's understandable. Yang you boleh relate adalah intern sahaja. Kalau tak ada, then Mr. Alfred suggest adalah go for technical skills. So FIP boleh cerita, project boleh cerita, you dapat grant tolong lecturer boleh cerita, jadi research assistant part time 3 bulan cuti sem boleh cerita. So a lot of things that you can go. Ini antara actually graduate tak tahu nak explain. Nak cerita apa They just mention one sentence habis.
And they don't usually elaborate. And the moment when you don't elaborate, you are losing out. And the more sad case is that a lot of them trying to fill out the space in the resume. They put like personal hobby. Then they talk about, you know,
unrelevant info.
Correct. That's very dangerous. Mm-hmm. Because the moment when you put all those stuff in your resume and the employer feel that, you know, this is macam kerja cincai lah. So I'm not going to hire you because I'm not interested in
Tuan Alfred, baik dia tak guna istilah saya. Itu rubbish ya, rubbish buang. Okay. So interesting, terima kasih Tuan Alfred. Banyak tadi from job application kepada resume kepada sedikit tentang career fair. Itu adalah satu journey seorang fresh grad yang baru grad memburu kerja. All those you need to experience. Ada orang rezeki just 2-3 application terus dapat. Ada orang they face challenges lah.
Yeah.
6 bulan, 5 bulan dah pergi banyak career fair but still masih lagi memburu. So just upgrade your document, resume, cover letter, email, the way you send, the way you approach, the way you establish first impression, just upgrade, upgrade, upgrade. Yeah. Along the way, you akan upgrade yourself dan kerja tu akan datang. Don't worry. Yeah. So, saya kira ada pesanan terakhir, Tuan Alfred? Okay. Apakah ada syarikat yang sesuai dengan minat kita? Gaji masuk, ada allowance, cuti banyak, increment ada tiap-tiap tahun, bonus pun ada. Macam perlu dua dengan kata tahun ni apa? 7 bulan, 8 bulan. Contoh kan. Ada satu masa PMB apa? 8 bulan, Petronas 6-7 bulan. Contoh. Adakah syarikat begitu wujud? Ataupun itu adalah kena they are give and take ke macam mana?
Well, I would say there's no perfect job in this world. And for anyone who is actually aspiring to look for that perfect job, I wish you all the best. but having said that, I believe probably there's some out there, but it's very rare.
Sangat rare.
Sangat-sangat rare. So if you happen to get those, you're super lucky.
Yes.
But for most of the people like us, I don't think we will get the kind of luck most of the time. Right. I would emphasize that because looking for a job or job searching is quite similar to like building a relationship. For example, you're looking for a perfect match, right? Yeah. So I'm pretty sure everybody fantasize about I want to get the perfect girl, yes, or the perfect guy to get married with and to establish a family.
Antara 15,000.
Yeah. So it's kind of the similar concept when a person thinks about their career. Yeah. We also want to look for the best job, the best company, the best package. But don't forget, that is just one part of the consideration. Mm-hmm. But if let's say you manage to get a job offer where it actually offers a lot of like room for you to grow, and also you also see the potential area where you can excel in your job performance, even though the benefits is not so much and it's not very high, but it's okay. It's the experience that you want to gain at the first place. Yep. So like I said, once again, you need to identify what would be your objective of life. Yeah. And at different age, probably you will have different focus.
True.
Yeah, then you work around your focus and your priority. Yeah. That's what I'm doing.
Betul.
Yeah.
Kalau umur 20, 2 series, mungkin anda lebih kepada, that's why bila buat survey, nak kepada gaji because you nak enjoy, nak rasa duit dan sebagainya. When you are 30, 3 series, you lebih kepada nak stabil. You tak nak ada relocate dan sebagainya, tak nak travel. 40, mungkin you mula merancang sisa-sisa kehidupan. 50, you are planning for your retirement.
Correct.
Apa retirement scheme sebagainya, bila nak beli rumah dekat mana, settle down dekat mana, anak cucu sebagainya. So every age stage akan ada objektif berbeza. Saya sangat suka apa yang Tuan Alfred kongsikan. Sama macam video kita buat sebelum ni. Objektif is the first thing you kena consider dulu. Benda lain dia akan datang.
Yeah.
Alright. So capai objektif, selesai. You pun puas hati. Alright. So terima kasih Tuan Alfred kerana bersama dengan kami.
Thank you.
Dan terima kasih kerana bersama kami di CareerCube Live. Banyak sangat perkongsian yang sangat menarik Tuan Alfred kongsikan yang sangat inline dengan CareerCube. Kami sangat suka benda ni. Kita bagi Tuan Alfred lepas ni. Okay, sebagai penutup, seperti dijanjikan, di pihak Grab Malaysia, mereka adalah menyediakan juga job portal. Yang kedua, mereka menganjurkan satu career fair yang antara yang terbesar dalam Malaysia. Di KLCC 29 Februari dan 1 Mac, we call it Mega Career and Study Fair. Okay, so nak datang ke sini kena register dulu tuan?
Kena register dekat kita punya website mcsf.com.
Register di sana mcasf.com. Pergi dan register.
Sebenarnya ada kelebihan dia. So selain daripada registration, you can also build your digital resume. dalam registration tu.
Okay, so yeah, apps kan?
Yeah, betul. Yeah. So whatever information they have filled up in the process, mm-hmm. it will automatically generate a digital resume for you to use during the fair.
Boleh print ke digital tu?
Boleh.
Oh, okay, yeah. Cool.
And one more thing is that you can also go through the personality test dalam app tu, Connect Now, and then to find out more about yourself.
Menarik.
Yeah.
Yang ni
so it will help you lah to discover yourself better and also how you want to pitch yourself in front of the majikan.
Yes. Yeah. Oh, sampai ada level boleh kenal diri you.
Yeah.
Okay. Mm. So sila lagi sekali kami ulang. Tengok di sini. MCSF.com, sila daftar dan jawab soalan di sana, isi profil anda. Dan saya di tahun lepas kami pernah pergi. Kami Carecube merupakan partner kepada Grab Malaysia.
Tahun ini juga.
Tahun ini juga, alhamdulillah. Yeah. Terima kasih kerana sudi berpartner lagi. Okay. Dan Carecube mereka adalah antara yang paling panggil interaktif kan. Ada QR code, anda datang dan anda scan dan anda dapat info-info syarikat dan syarikat dapat info anda. Hanya scan sahaja.
Yeah.
So dia macam anda datang bergaya lenggan kangkung scan. So macam okay.
Scanning is one thing lah. Make sure you give a good impression.
Yeah. Yeah. The traditional way masih lagi pula. Yes, jangan datang scan pula. Tak ada.
Yes.
No. Mm. Okay, baik. Terima kasih lagi sekali Great Malaysia diwakili oleh Tuan Alfred kerana berkongsi benda yang sangat bermanfaat untuk kita hari ini. Yeah. So, stay tune untuk minggu depan dan minggu-minggu akan datang.
Terima kasih.
Dan yang terakhir adalah nak konten, kami berkongsi secara harian di Telegram Rahsia Dapat Kerja KDQ. So, join dan kita bertemu di pelbagai platform lagi. Bye-bye.